It had been a couple of months since Oliver and Bear were purchased by the Northwestern Railway around that same time. An engine from the mainland, a vagrant steamer by the name of Dudley, had temporarily arrived on the island and had tried to cause a rift between the resident engines and the high-mech diesel. After his acts of deceit were found out, the Fat Controller had sent the huge engine packing. Dudley complied, but not without giving him a cold warning.
Perhaps this railway isn't any different after all. You call this deceit? Ho ho ho, my dear sir, it is survival. The only thing that matters in the age of scrap. Well, you've won the battle, but not the war. I'll take my leave at your request, but you will remember me.
He had said to the Fat Controller before taking his leave. Now, however, times have changed. When Dudley returned to the mainland, the greeting he got was one that would have sent chills through even the worst of engines.
I have heard about your recent excursion to Sir Charles Topham Hatt's railway, the manager began, an icy glare on his face. If I recall correctly, you would even the engine originally rostered take that goods train to Sodor to begin with. I'd given the job to 199, only to find out he had coincidentally derailed in the same yard you were in.
You have no evidence that proves I'd done anything to that oversized tin can, sir. Dudley huffed, rolling his eyes.
Quite the contrary, Dudley, the manager replied. I was told about how you had your driver sabotage the points that led to 199 derailing himself from one of the shunters. It seems that even then you were willing to do whatever it took to ensure your survival at the cost of our operations.
Dudley's eyes shifted toward the manager, a glare in his face that matched that of the man standing before him.
I'm a useful engine, sir, snapped Dudley. I don't see the need in replacing myself and my fellow steam engines with those oversized petrol cans. Times are changing, I'm afraid, the manager said in a stern yet sullen voice. We cannot afford to keep up on the maintenance of you and other steam engines as well as the care needed to keep the diesels running. Starting today, you are to be withdrawn from service and scrapped when there's an opening at Berry Island.
A diesel shunter slowly reversed toward Dudley, a grim look on her face.
Sir, you can't do this! Give me another chance. I promise to do better, Dudley pleaded, his expression changing to one of genuine fear. I'm sorry, but after your little stunt on Sodor, I'm not taking any more chances of you trying to sabotage British Rail's operations, the manager said, turning his back on Dudley. Take him away, and put him in a shed away from the others. We don't want him getting up to his old tricks yet again.
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
Replied the diesel. And with a honk of her horn, she hauled Dudley away. Night had just fallen as the shunter reversed him into an old double-track shed and left to resume her late-night work.
That foolish man will change his mind when he realizes that most of the railway will go under without me to handle the increased workload, Dudley muttered to himself, gazing up at the starry sky. Might as well get some shut-eye to pass the time.
And without another word, Dudley shut his eyes and drifted off to sleep. 3 years had passed since Dudley had been withdrawn. During that whole time, no one came to see him. His already shabby coat of paint now began to develop severe rust patches near the shed, where sidings had once been filled with trucks and coaches waiting to get to their destinations. Dilapidated steam engines stood waiting for their turn to be sent to Berry Isle to be cut up. Dudley looked around at the morbid sight, his eyes widening to sheer, genuine horror.
This is horrible, he exclaimed to no one in particular. They cannot do this to me and my brethren. Quiet, you! Came a voice. Who said that? Dudley asked, his eyes darting from left to right, seeking out the mysterious voice.
A combination of creaking and puffing filled the air as an elderly steam engine appeared before Dudley. Its once pristine green livery was now a shabby, weathered mess. Patches of rust could be seen on its buffers, splashers, and sides of its tender.
Who are you? Asked Dudley, trying to take in the sight of the engine before him. I am, or shall I say I was, known as Great Northern.
The engine answered, his gaze unwavering.
What are you doing here? Actually, how did you even get here in the first place?
Quizzed Dudley.
I was once like you, cousin. I thought I was an indispensable engine. That could never be touched. Funny how a big head has a way of clouding one's judgment. What do you say?
Smirked Great Northern.
You wouldn't understand, sneered Dudley. I was an engine well in my prime, top of the line for freight work with a slight pinch of passenger work added to the mix. I was the pinnacle of strength and speed for my class. And yet, when those tin rats started to creep in, the management decided it was easier to give myself and my fellow brethren the cutter's torch.
Oh, believe me, I do understand,
Great Northern replied, his smirk turning into a dark glare.
The difference between you and me, though, when my time came, I didn't resort to dirty, underhanded tricks to try and ensure my survival as you have. You should have considered yourself fortunate to even have lasted this long. You vile excuse of an engine!
Now see here,
I'm not finished yet!
The specter interrupted.
Look around you at these poor, lifeless husks. Many of these poor, unfortunate souls would have given their left bolts to have even half the fortune you had. You had a chance to find a new home for yourself. But you resorted to your old ways and threw that chance out the window. To be frank, What you're enduring is a fate worse than death itself.
Be gone!
Snarled Dudley, glaring daggers at Great Northern.
You claim to know me and my struggles, but you don't. You know nothing. You'll see one day. I'll get my chance to show what I'm made of once more. And if I have to resort to taking out those rattletrap diesels, I will. You'll see. You'll all see.
Great Northern said nothing more, as Dudley began to cackle like a madman. With a look of regret on his face, he reversed away and disappeared into the night, leaving behind a crazed engine. Eventually, the time had come for Dudley to be scrapped. When the workers found him, it had looked like he'd merely fallen asleep, but after their inspection, he never awoke. Ironically, Berry Isle had become so full of withdrawn engines, there wasn't room for him to be cut up there. Instead, the manager decided to put Dudley on the dead train bound for the scrapyards on Sodor. Upon arrival, the twin diesels that resided there, Airy and Bert, were getting help from the island's other shunter, simply known as Diesel. The O-8 had consulted a scheme to get a fright out of the twins. But I mustn't say any more, or else I shall spoil the next story.